Welcome back to the Sage Audio Channel. Today we're talking about how to compress your master. But first, if you have a mix, send it to us at sageaudio.com to receive a free mastered sample of it. Use optical compression for a smooth master. Optical compression has a unique timbre to it, and it can add a lot of character to your master. The reason being, it typically holds onto the signal for longer than regular compression, and it releases it in stages depending on the incoming signal's amplitude and other factors. In that regard, it's a program-dependent form of compression that can make a master sound smooth and full if used correctly. Notice that the optical setting creates a naturally slow release, and it pairs it with a very soft knee setting. This results in a smooth transition into compression. Additionally, the longer release time and soft knee create a uniformity to the signal, often referred to as glue. Use saturation to create a full master. Saturation is a combination of both soft knee compression and harmonic distortion, making it a powerful tool to use during your mastering session. The soft knee compression controls dynamics, while the harmonic distortion makes fundamental frequencies easier to hear and creates a fuller, louder sound. When using saturation, imagine your peaks being reduced while quieter aspects of the signal are pushed upward, making them louder. Try different saturation types to introduce different harmonic formations. For example, tube saturation introduces a strong second-order harmonic, which almost has a doubling effect. This lower-order harmonic also results in a warm sound. How to set your release when mastering? The release time is one of the most important and influential aspects of compression, especially during a mastering session. It has the power to completely change the timbre of your master by either attenuating transients or letting a portion of them pass through. First and foremost, if you're using a compressor on a full master, your release time should be at least 50 milliseconds. Anything quicker will distort lower frequencies since the release will be shorter than the actual waveform. With 50 milliseconds, you'll get a really transparent sound since the amplitude of the track will be returned to normal very quickly after compression. For a smoother or glued together sound, use a longer release time. How to set your attack when mastering. The compressor's attack is almost as important as its release. Generally speaking, use a longer attack to cause less compression and create a louder overall signal, or a shorter attack for more compression and a smoother sound. Like a very quick release time, a very quick attack time can cause distortion. If you set it super quick, it'll cut into the transient, in turn distorting the waveform. With that in mind, avoid very fast attack times when you're mastering. Also, it might help to set the attack time and possibly your release time to be in tempo with your track. To do this, divide 60,000 by the BPM of your song to get a quarter note in milliseconds. Use sidechain compression when mastering. When you're compressing during a mastering session, you can use the internal sidechain of the compressor to reduce the effect of compression on certain frequencies. Although the full bandwidth will still be compressed, you can use sidechain compression to avoid having certain frequencies trigger the compressor. This is especially useful when you're mastering music with a lot of low frequencies. Since the kick of rap, pop, rock, and other genres holds the majority of the signal's dynamics, these low frequencies are often the first to trigger compression. With the internal sidechain enabled, cut these frequencies out, in turn avoiding compression being caused by them. Now this will make your master more dynamic while retaining low frequency instrumentation. Using hard or soft knee compression when mastering. The knee you choose when you're mastering affects the sound of the compression and can result in a smooth sounding master or an aggressive and transient one. For a smoother sounding master, use a soft knee setting. For an aggressive sounding one, use a hard knee setting. Now keep in mind that a soft knee setting will cause more compression since the compression begins at a lower amplitude. However, the compression will be more gradual. It'll compress quieter parts less and louder parts more. Hard knee compression, on the other hand, is more accurate and only occurs when the signal is loud enough. It's also typically more linear in that the compression occurs at a constant rate. If you have a mix, send it to us at sageaudio.com to receive a free mastered sample of it. Also, stay up to date by subscribing and liking the video. Lastly, let us know your thoughts in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching.